couldn't go home. It is getting a little bit easier, but it's putting the key in the door and knowing that Jim isn't there at the other side. I've sort of, in my own mind, put him on holiday. I'm rational and I know he's not coming back, but the way of coping is that eventually I know I will meet him again because I believe in that. So every day to me is a day nearer meeting him. Every day I have a routine before I go to bed, and it could, some people could say it's an obsession. It's a comfort. I have to say goodnight to him. I still sleep on only my side of the bed. I do not cross over onto his side of the bed at all. I'm very conscious of that, and if I have, I wake up. It's nearly an immediate thing that I do. I wake up and think, oh my God, I can't lie on that side of the bed. That belongs to him still. I speak to him before I go to bed, I speak to him when I get up, I speak to him when I come in from work. Just letting him know I'm home, I'm safe. This is the part where I have to come in. And the flowers are because I were told that if you put flowers outside of the pictures, they believe in the afterlife that you're still caring and thinking about them. So hence the full obsession of flowers around his picture. So, and I also have to come in because that's his work picture, and I also have to come in and make sure I've seen him. And that picture is outside of my bed, and I feel safe and secure once I've been and seen him. Right, coffee. I start to cry. The feeling of praying to die every night has gone. In fact, the feeling of wanting to live has sort of come back. I realise that life goes on. You don't like it. Don't want it to. I would much rather have my life as it was. I would swap everything and have it back as it was, but it has to go on. That's it, that's the end of my night, pal. A cup of coffee and my fag. It's done, gone, over, finished, kaput. Are you done?
Yeah, before Friday at the races, he has been a bit quiet tonight. Could have done him being a bit busier. Some middle-aged women, that's what we need. In bucket taxis. These young girls are still at school. Oh, well.
Next Tuesday at 10, Bob Monkhouse salutes comedy's funniest freethinkers from Spike Milligan to Harry Hill in What a Performance. Next here on ITV, the nightly news, so stay with us.